Welcome back, everybody, to Mass Effect Andromeda. Okay, I did want to record a little more the other night, but I decided not to. Why? Because I heard the patch was coming out. Yes, it is finally here. Apparently, they've done something with the eyes and the animations and all of that. This is their first patch to attempt to fix some of the crazy things that are happening with Andromeda. So I'm actually very happy because when when we last left off, we were still trying to talk to the crew. So we're going to continue to do that, and then we're going to head over to the Nexus and talk to them some more.
In the armory.
It actually works out quite well. Well, this is our first time logging on, so let's collect all of our stuff. Oh, that's in-game time. Okay, so this is real world time. The Andromeda points or whatever, those are in game time. Okay. Oh man, this guy just rocks out with his cock out. What happened? Did the game freeze on me? What's going on? Okay. I don't know what to do. Okay, there we go. That was strange. It wouldn't let me hit A. I actually had to switch screens. Luckily, I was about to quit out and end the video, thankfully. But these guys are coming along much better now. They couldn't get a successful mission to save their life, but now we're cooking with gas. All right, how about another bronze apex mission? How about Lima? Got 86%. I like those chances. How about you? Oh no, you still only got a 21%. I gotta start upgrading that guy. How about this? You know, honestly, I wish when you click on the mission, they have to have a way to do this better. Like, I hate having to hit send strike team each time. Like, this should really take you to the strike team screen, and it should take you here. And if you actually want to do it in multiplayer mode, here's where your options should be. You should be able to come down onto this screen and play it in the multiplayer mode instead of every Apex mission, it's saying, hey, do you want to play this in multiplayer? Look, I don't want to go into multiplayer all the time, and honestly, I haven't yet. But that is one thing I hope BioWare picks up on and improves. They are committed to making some UI changes and quality of life improvements, so hopefully this is one of them. I'm not entirely sure what this is doing for me right now, but I think it is, I think it's actually upgrading my PvP stats. Oh wow, look at all these loot boxes I have. Helios research data. More Helios. Milky Way data. There's a lag on this. I'm wondering if this is an online component. Ruzad. What is that? That's another thing I would like it to tell me. What is this? Is it a shotgun? I mean, it looks like a shotgun. But it'd be nice if it gave you maybe a little descriptor of the gun. At least what it is. Obviously, that's a shotgun. Got nickel. All right, I'm liking these silver loot boxes. Credits. I don't know how many I got there. Rieger carbine. That, wow, rare. That might actually be worth taking a look at.
Pathfinder, you have new email.
I do. Okay, let's go check that out. I hope I saved in at the correct spot. I'd hate to go through all of those freaking emails again. Data cores, Ryder from PP. Hey, Ryder. Hope it's okay that I'm keeping this data core in my room, the escape pod. I guess I just really like to ponder things before bed. The best ideas come to me while I'm half asleep. See, that's why I can't sleep, which is why I'm an insomniac, because I keep thinking the whole night. Anyway, also I saw it first. Anyway, we know for sure it's got some sort of data in it. The trick is how to get at it. I'll keep you updated. What I have to wonder is, PB is incredibly immature. She's probably the most immature Asari we've ever seen, which makes me wonder how old she is in relationship to Liara. Liara was only 100? 100 or 200, I can't remember, which is something like 20% of the Asari lifespan, if that. So it kind of makes me think PB might actually be even younger, the way she acts. I don't know. Anyway, let's archive that, and I need to quit talking and get to talking to some more people. Keep getting distracted. And you guys are probably going, shut up and go. So let's shut up and go. Giggity giggity.
Hey, Drax. Devil's advocate, okay?
Go for it.
With the Ket entrenched here and things as they are, maybe we should focus our efforts on leaving this cluster.
You mean quit? Run away?
Well, we came to find a new home, not a new enemy, right?
We knew this was a possible scenario, and we took the jump anyway.
What she said.
Right, and where the hell are you gonna go? You already basically said you can't go back into cryo because you don't have the power. Alright, what do you gotta say, Drac?
Thought you should know I keep finding crumbs here on the counter.
Is it significant?
So we have a few messy eaters on board.
I think something's nibbling our stores. Something that doesn't belong. Possibly something tasty.
I'll keep an eye out for stowaways.
Are we gonna find Space Hamster?
We can talk more later.
Sure.
I love Drac. I pretty much love just about every Krogan character. Follow the crumb trail. What crumb trail? I am a little unclear what crumb trail he's referring to, but I guess we'll get to that. Derp. Alright, so this is the Archon mission.
Gil, here's that Ket transponder. The spy used it to get his orders.
What do we need from it?
The location it points to. Should give us a fix on the Archon's ship.
Right.
Woo, I don't know what they did in this patch, but my FPS died. Wow. I'm sitting at 47 FPS. Similar scenes. I was up at 80 before the patch. Yikes. Optimization. Okay. You can do it, Gil.
Think you can figure it out?
I've been looking over the care tech we found so far. It may be a different galaxy, but physics still applies. Only so many ways of communicating across space. There. Give it a shot.
Did you connect the...
Shit, turn it off. Careful. That is a direct line to people who want to murder everyone on this ship.
Sam?
I have the coordinates. The signal points to the Tafino system.
We sure we want to do this?
We've got to.
I know we're still getting our feet wet, but I don't see another choice.
I knew running off to Andromeda would be dangerous, but shit. This is dangerous.
Only if we die.
On hold. Wait for PB to learn more about the remnant. Okay. Well, yeah. Locate the Ket flagship. Okay, this is perfect. Wow, that's really weird. In conversations, I was getting... well, excellent frames per second. Something like 80, 90. Now I've been dipping into the 40s. But back on the ship running around, I'm back in the 70s. It's, strange, to say the least. If you guys don't mind, the patch could have screwed with something. Let me check my graphics settings. I did just have NVIDIA. excuse me. I had NVIDIA kind of do their little optimization on their own, but sometimes their optimizations aren't the best. Simulates natural diffusion of color. overall quality, custom. Texture quality, ultra, we do want that. We don't really want temporal A. Yeah, we could go down to FXAA, but temporal AA is fine. I don't know what ambient occlusion is. We'll leave that. Depth of field, motion blur. We could turn motion blur off. Texture filtering, ultra, lighting quality, high, medium. Effects quality, yeah, that's just like the particles coming out of your gun. We don't need that at high. Mesh quality. My only problem with coming back to PC gaming after so long is I don't remember what half of these settings do. Terrain quality. I definitely want to keep terrain and vegetation quality high. Actually, I'd rather have them at ultra and turn down other stuff. I don't know. Compress 32 bits. I don't know what the hell that does. I didn't change anything. So, how about video output? Yeah, we're good there. You know, we're never gonna hit 144 hertz. So let's turn us down to 120 hertz. VSync is off. HDR. I don't know if I have an HDR monitor or not. Triple buffering on. Off? I don't know what that does. Okay, well, what we're going to do is I never really hit 144 hertz anyway, unless we're kind of not using anything. So that will be fine. I will research. Whoa, what do we got flash in there? Why is the background flashing? Is that supposed to flash? Maybe. Maybe I just hadn't noticed it before. I need to stop. I'm sorry. All right, let's go down and talk to peoples, and I'm not going to worry about my... Whoop. Aha!
Something's nesting here. Something that likes cereal. I wonder. We've probably got materials to build a humane trap and catch it.
Build a trap at a research center. Okay, well, I can build that upstairs next time I'm there. Looks like we don't have Liam. You know, I thought Liam was gonna be, like, my new BFF, like, space buddy, but... Man, he's a whiny little turd a lot of times. Cora, what's up?
We got it, Ryder.
You patched up the Asari flight recorder?
Some old access codes, a little data recovery from Sam. We have the Asari Ark's last heading. Nav points are set. We can head there whenever you're ready.
Remember the survey ship? This might not be pretty. Are you...
Handling tough stuff is my job. We need the Asari and Sarissa more than ever. I trust you to find them before the Ket do.
It's really hard for me to tell in the conversations with Cora. We're going to have to go visit my face is tired lady and see how that looks in comparison the last time.
Pirates, exiles, severed heads. Kadara Port's a peach, huh? And Sloane Kelly is the pit. Anything you needed?
You know, I thought I was going to get more flirt options
see
with
you later,
her.
Cora.
But... Then again,
I'll be here.
I don't know how far we are into the game right now. The one thing I did notice is I forgot they kind of buried this in the menu. You know, we've got all this good stuff right here. But down there at the bottom in the middle, you see Andromeda viability. And I haven't visited this that much. And if, as you can see, we found 4 out of the 5 viable planets. Obviously, we've got a lot of work to do on Havaro Kadara, and we still got to find the other one, which I think we already know where that's at. Well, I mean, it's unlocked for us, and we can go to it, but I want to think we're pretty damn far into the game. And I haven't really had a successful romance besides PB. And that was meant to be a one-night stand kind of thing.
if any of your meals pass the bucket test.
You lost me.
Picture your favorite food. Now picture it in a bucket beside a barn. Would you still eat it?
Do all humans try to ruin everything? Or just you?
Yeah, no kidding. Like, if my favorite food was in a bucket beside a barn, I still wouldn't eat it. Whoa, that was a weird jump.
Tev Uni. A home on Vold. Sort of. Still feels good, though.
I do notice a little more movement in their eyes. Around the whole eye socket area, there's more emotion, it seems, when they're talking.
Just checking in. I wanted to ask about you.
What do you want to know?
The people of Hustle. Do the hustle.
Tell me about your friends in crisis response.
I swore I wouldn't tell anyone what they did. Stealing the shuttle for the car was above and beyond. Dondi, Bass, Mazzy, Noel, Cap, and goddamn Hammond. The best people when buildings have fallen down. Eventually, I'll have to start a new branch here, you know? I promised.
I have to know about the car.
We'd wrench on it as a family. Mom suggested it, and Dad liked a happy mom. That's how I fell into mechanical stuff. Armor and jump jets. Mom wasn't a fan of the second part. You know how it is.
Yeah, it does sound pretty familiar.
I worried my parents from time to time.
That's a kid's job. I probably crossed the line a few times, though. Like jumping a galaxy. That's why I have to make this work. If I don't, then Andromeda was a mistake. I said goodbye to too many people to let that happen.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
What's bothering me is these conversations are so short with these guys. We're getting, like, really strange flashes going on now. And I'm not sure why. What did I change? It didn't help my FPS. So let me go back. I don't think this has anything to do with it. But I'm going to set that back to my monitor resolution. And, see what that does. It could be the patch. It's a bad idea for me to change anything right now. With the patch being the way it is. Well, see, now nothing's flashing. Maybe it was that. Maybe me changing the refresh rate screwed it up. Okay. Alright. How about the crew info board? Yes, we got a new one. Lost and found hot patch gun. Lost this from my workbench yesterday, and I'm really hoping it didn't fall through the deck plating. Gil. Comments. I borrowed it to fix a loose sole on my boot. I'm almost done. Liam. Liam, can I grab that quickly after? I need to patch a strap. Cora. Oh, the pilot seat cushion just needs a quick fix too. Callow. That would really help a rickety shelf I've got down here. Vetra. I built another hot patch gun. You guys can fight over that one. Speaking of Vetra. Oh no! We completely overlooked Vetra.
Hey, Ryder. Got an encrypted message from Sid. She has news and wanted to talk to us both. Connecting the call now.
Finally! I've been waiting for hours.
So you want to tell us what this is all about?
I was listening to outpost updates and caught a message about settlers going missing.
Missing?
What do you mean they're missing?
They didn't leave voluntarily. No work assignments, no mining expeditions, kidnapped. I dug around, and I think I know where they've been taken. A cave on a moon in the Ramav system. Originally an Angaran mine, I think, but they abandoned it.
I don't believe the planet you're talking about is a moon.
Whatever.
What did I tell you about getting involved?
I couldn't just do nothing.
How do we know your intel's even reliable?
It's reliable.
Huh. We'll check it out.
I trust your sister, and there's no sense in wasting time.
See? That's a pathfinder.
Sid, just give us everything you have on this.
Already done. Could I come along? I want to help.
You know the answer to that.
Right, of course. Stay away from bad people, guns, bombs, Krogan beer.
Krogan beer.
You did good. I just want you to be safe, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, come to think of it, now that we're just starting to get essentially loyalty missions for most people, maybe I'm thinking we're about halfway through the game. Have we read this datapad? You don't need an old man a few hundred years junior to tell you you're ready for... Oh, okay, yeah. That was for when she first came on the ship.
Everything all right?
Oh, yes. PB and I were just having a debate.
Yeah, that's one word for it.
You mean argument?
No, that would be unprofessional.
If you say so.
Ryder, do you think I'm uptight?
I...
No, never mind. Don't answer that. Let's just talk about something else.
Damn it! I would actually like to answer that question and have a conversation, but damn it.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Okay, who haven't we talked to? I think that's everybody, unless there's somebody, no? That's just the end of meta... Oh! Can't believe I missed that. Wow. We shouldn't have anything else here at Sam Node. That's just my emails. Let's go up on the ladder. We've already talked to PB. We have already talked to PB, haven't we? I think we did that last episode. Oh, well, you know what? We're right here. Let's, just to be safe.
I take it you moved your stuff over from the Nexus?
Yeah. My squatter's paradise is all the more cluttered. What's up?
I don't want to flirt with her anymore because I don't want a serious relationship with her. So we're gonna leave it at that.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
Oh, and I think one of the best things that they patched is coming up. You can skip the planet-to-planet animation now. Thank God. But we're gonna head on to the Tempest and talk to a whole lot of people there now. If you're watching the Mass Effect series and you are... It may be boring to watch. I don't know. I've never really watched a playthrough of Mass Effect. But playing it, I love the story. I love the characters. But if you don't like hours of just running around, talking to people, and exploring, Mass Effect definitely isn't for you. If you do enjoy those things, Mass Effect is one of the... To me, the perfect mix. Now, the execution of that mix is debatable, but...
Pathfinder, this is Captain Dunn. There's a situation I could use your assistance with. I'd rather not discuss it over open channels. Please come see me on the Hyperion Bridge as soon as you can.
Right, I remember that email. What did this terminal do again? Oh, that's the news network. Wow, there's new side missions in here and everything.
Do more good out there than I can.
Things are still going smoothly without me to look over them?
Who is we're Carrie?
I told you we'd manage.
Damn.
You're back safe. You... No, no, Carrie. Professional. First things first. Tan sent a little gift for your positive message. I'd make the most of it. Today's a tough one. The Exiles. Probably the most live-wire topic for our leaders. You've met the treacherous mutineers at Kadara Port. Some think the Exiles are a menace to be eradicated.
They're not the See, that statement over here is true but false. Because they are a threat, but they're not the real enemy.
The Exiles have as many problems as the Initiative. Not every outlaw wants us dead.
Wow, it's almost heresy to hear that the Exiles are anything but filthy... Well, Exiles... I wish I could draw this out, but I have a meeting. Sorry. Apparently some colonists want to talk about the series. Maybe they'll be willing to go on camera.
Hmm. That almost sounds like a bad omen. Oh, wait. I wanted to talk to Vetra, see if she's got anything to say.
Damn, Ryder, you just missed a good show. One of the alarms malfunctioned, and we thought it was an attack. Didn't take long to figure it out, but in that time, they managed to scramble at least half the station's defenses.
Another malfunction?
Why are the alarms still malfunctioning?
Probably a leftover issue from when the Scourge fried systems. It's not that bad. I once worked in a building with a fire alarm that would glitch every other week.
Pathfinder Ryder, a word, please.
Good.
I stopped an unauthorized shipment to Kadara. Important stuff. Rations, tools, power cells, you name it. Corresponds with inventory discrepancies. Someone's stealing and storing supplies around Nexus and Hyperion for delivery to the Exiles. If you could keep an eye out for suspicious or out-of-place packages, I'd appreciate it.
I'll see what I can do.
Absolutely.
Great. Stolen supplies haven't been processed for release, so Sam should be able to detect them.
Search Hyperion.
Hi, I'm Jean Garth,
Habitat. Search comms area. Well, shit. We'll have to do that kind of as one mission because that's three different locations that I have no idea or remember how to get to. All right, let's head into here. Oh, here's a new side mission.
Interesting place, isn't it? Full of smiles and handshakes. Not many soldiers. Even though when politicians make peace, it's we soldiers who keep it.
Given our situation, it's smart to show we truly come in friendship.
Though in these times, you should be prepared for the alternative. But names. I know you, Pathfinder. I am Andromeda-Part, a Heskarl with the Resistance.
A Heskarl?
Centuries ago, Heskarl were special forces. We defended colonies, passing our training down via oral history. Few remember us today. I came to learn what the Milky Way knows of such things. I heard your father was part of a similar program, an N7.
Well, I'll tell you all about the N7.
What have you learned about the N7 program?
Human soldiers who trained on exotic worlds. Arcturus, Europa, Rio de Janeiro. They learn to fight in all environments on little food or sleep, to care for their injured, to lead. Is that accurate? Wasn't your father one of them?
Yes.
He was one of the first N7s. He was proud of that, even though he didn't stay in service. Didn't stop him teaching me and my sister a few tricks.
So, you carry a little of that knowledge with you, as well as your Pathfinder skills. N7 training would benefit my people. Heskarl training would benefit yours. Perhaps a few war games. Show me how your skills handle the tests of a Heskarl recruit. Challenge yourself and teach me.
Oh, hell yeah. That actually sounds pretty awesome.
A chance to work with the Angaran best of the best? Absolutely.
Excellent. I'll activate our training beacons. Finding them can be your first test. After that, I look forward to learning.
Okay, that does seem pretty dang awesome. Battle the Remnant, battle ancient furious creatures, retrieve sensitive data. So, things I've already been doing? Jal, what's up, buddy?
Ryder, I just read the most fascinating histories about the conflict between the Geth and their Quarian creators. I feel like the Angara and the Quarians have so much in common.
Really? How?
We're both displaced, struggling against cruel enemies to save our home worlds.
But the Ket just showed up here. That's not your fault. The Quarians created the Geth.
Home is home. When home is not safe, the heart is sick from yearning.
Don't hesitate to speak with one of our friendly people.
Got a point. Wow, there's so much to do, and I love it. I love all the Angarans in here, just running around and learning about our culture now. It's, well, it's freaking awesome.
Hello again.
How did you get this job?
I was a sociologist in the Milky Way. While there were plenty of cultures to study, the books on them had all been written. There was nothing new I could add. So when I heard about the initiative, I signed up right away. The idea of meeting new people, seeing how they've evolved, adapted to life's challenges, I couldn't resist.
What goes on here?
The Cultural Center is a place where new races we've met can visit and exchange ideas. They can learn more about the Milky Way species, while we foster an air of cooperation and understanding. You've already brought us our first visitors by making contact with the Angara.
Oh, well, that's cool that the conversation changed because we met the Angara. Because I would assume that it would be something different since we did not ask that question previously.
Thanks.
Of course.
What the hell? Wow, graphics are weird. I mean, it sounds like I have a ton of knowledge in my videos, but I don't. I'd just like to put that out there. It's been about 15 years or more since I was really heavy into the PC scene.
Should I apply for an outpost?
She just tracked me down, right? Am I wrong about that? But anyway, I'm still kind of relearning the ropes. Like, I know enough to be dangerous. But I would definitely like to know more. I know one of the first missions I want to do when we get off of here is go to that camp where that guy sabotaged Sam. I want to cover every square inch. Matter of fact, let's hit a vendor.
When will I help get this you part off local traders?
General merchant. Oh, yeah. One of the third things that I remember correctly now is if you look at my item limit, item max used to be 65. They increased that massively. Thank God, because with this massive crafting system and everything else of that nature, it's kind of ridiculous to have what they had. Double mod extension. Buy it. Excuse me. Mod slot extension. I want a lot of those because I would definitely love that. Okay, do you have any weapons? Oh. What do we have for assault rifle mods? AR stock 4th. Ooh. Okay. How about sniper rifle mods? Because those are my main weapons. Ultralight materials. Buy that. Whoop. Ah, dang it. Gotta get used to the menus again. Any armor? No. Any... I don't need any of those. As of right now, I'm... Ooh, augmentations. Anti-armor module? I don't know what I want for augs. Shield support power module. Power restoration, defense power. Shield bypass unit. Provides a bonus to one or more stats when used in the development of an item. These all look pretty low rate, actually. Do you have any nomad stuff? Oh! Oh, cool! Buying it. Awesome, we're filling out my cabin now. Now, the next thing to do is see if to sell my items. I have 3 remnant decryption keys, Liam's armor. Can I sell that now? Oh, well, I won't sell anything to her. I'll just go to the next merchant. That's all you have, right? Nomad mods, agility module. Allows the Nomad's stability assist, which is always on by default, to be disabled, giving an expert driver greater control of the vehicle. With stability assist disabled, the Nomad is more agile, but will have less traction when cornering. Oh, that could be fun. But press... It said press what to switch between modes? Press... It doesn't tell me. But we're going to buy it. We're going on a spending spree here. supplemental life support. Upgrade the Nomad's life support systems to improve functioning in extreme environments. Yes. We actually do want that. That's getting kind of expensive. We've got a few more stores to hit before we head to the tram station anyway. We will be going upstairs eventually. Back upstairs anyway.
I'm still...
Arm shop. Okay, so let's break this down. Assault rifles. No, I don't want that one. LS snipers. No, Viper. Melee. What do you got? Omniblade 4. I kind of like my sword, but the Omniblade hits faster. I'll craft an Omniblade, I think. That seems like a better idea. Nada. How about you? Armor. N7 armor 4. What am I wearing right now? I really hope they add that functionality to the game because... Is there a compare functionality? Damn it. You know what? I'd rather craft the better helmets. Yeah.
We just got set up.
So what we'll do is we'll just sell off... Actually, you know what?
Give it some time.
We're at 55 items. Let's become a hoarder for a little while and...
My team and I surveyed Eos thoroughly and even stopped the storms. The rest is up to the outpost. But the old threats are gone.
Who the hell was he talking to?
Pathfinder.
Oh, that was it. Alright. Fair enough. Oh, we do have an herb to drop at the bar. You can find me in the club.
Pathfinder Rider. I need to know something from you.
Shoot.
You've been to Gadara. You've seen the exiles there. They used to be with us. Friends, family, co-workers. A lot of us worry about them. We hear it's chaos, that it's dog-eat-dog.
Concerned faceless citizen. It's pretty bad.
It's hard living. They have to watch their backs and do whatever it takes to survive.
So scary. Despite what happened, my heart goes out to them. Thank you for taking the time.
I'm gonna mute my mic for a second or two as I just popped in a piece of beef jerky, and I'm sure you guys would appreciate not listening to that.
Interesting. Thanks, Pathfinder.
Angara have adapted in such a harsh cluster. How is their metabolism?
any EMP charge through their skin.
Fascinating. Could you get us a measurement? Even a handshake would do.
That's right. We are going to develop that hamster cage. I was all ready to craft that, and then I forgot I'm not level 30. Damn it. I'll get there,
though. Byzantine crystalline. All the nodules intertwine.
Huh. Nothing?
The beauty of the cosmos unfolds in your planet scans, Pathfinder. But there is more they can do.
How can I help?
Do you have something in mind, Doctor?
Plans for a school are underway to inspire a new generation of young minds. I want to craft a model of the cluster for them, accurate and splendid from your data. My prototype is on that console. Add more scans to improve it, and I will share my educational budget with you, and my thanks.
Oh, so it's like the education lottery. Gotcha. But do we at least get to see her model? Like the start of it? Oh! Cluster model, Dr. Limbadria. Three initial system models will be complete by next week. We should seek our place in the world. Orbital variance for the Nexus will be corrected as construction corrects our orientation. As a reminder, our daughters will not know that stasis the 600 years sleeping. They will be born of Andromeda and whatever is unfolding. This cluster is chaos, was not welcoming. This cluster in its chaos was not welcoming. But it matters less what we suffer here, more what we bring. I don't know what kind of poetry that was, but alright. I think these are missions. Final proposer, professor. Since we are, by definition, an invasive species in Andromeda, our inevitable footprint must be laid carefully, and we must preserve anything we replace. Wait. We've read that. Geophysicist's beta build. Customize. Yeah. Yeah, we've read all those. I'm not sure why there's... Oh! Woohoo! We completed it already. Did I hit level 60 by any chance? 30, I mean? No. Damn it. Okay, so back down to the tram.
Hey, did you catch your latest delivery?
Yep.
Then we will go to one area at a time. I think we're actually going to start at the cryo bay and then work our way to the right.
Exiles find a home as former security are implicated in the mutiny. An investigation revealed Nexus security head Sloan Kelly played a role in the uprising that killed dozens. Initiative authorities track the exiles, including Kelly, to Kadara, a desert planet in the Gavorkum system. Initiative Director Jaren Tan did not mince words when news of the exile port was made public.
Kadara is dangerous. The exiles are dangerous. Stay away from Kadara. I cannot stress this enough.
This is HNS.
I don't know what I'm looking for, but...
665 years old?
And think about this.
Oh, derp.
These are stolen supplies. I'll alert the dock manager.
Huh. Okay. Now let's go see if anybody needs anything. And when the hell does my sister get woken up? It's been too long, and I'm a writer, and I demand she be woken up.
I didn't want to take any risks in a new galaxy.
And your appendix?
I'm sure. Your adenoids? Bacteria.
Back for a visit?
Oh my god, excuse me.
How's Sarah doing?
Everything seems fine. Hearing your voice had to help. Even if you did bend the truth there.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
I'll be here if you need me.
Well, crap. I was hoping something would be updated. All right. Guess not. Habitation bay. Well, deck. I hope you guys will be happy to know next up on my list of purchases is probably going to be actual mic that has a noise gate on it and cuts out ambient noise because, you know, with between my cats and my occasional lip smacks and all of that, it, you know, I just got a regular headset mic. I'd like these videos to become a little more professional. A little. Not much, though.
Baby, where are you?
Hey, Vetra. I'm someplace interesting.
Want to meet up? Maybe at the Nexus Lounge?
Appreciate the invite. Rain check, okay?
Sure thing.
Huh.
Still not spending time in the Nexus, huh?
No, I made the rounds. Tons more people milling about. My old apartment's been appropriated. Guess they need the space.
Yeah?
You seem sad about that.
Not sad, exactly. Guess I just realized how nice it was to have a quiet place where I could disappear. Now, everywhere you go, boom, people.
You live on a spaceship. Nobody to run into but people. And the captain, which wanted to speak to us, is right here.
Sorry to call you in, but this is best handled discreetly.
Talk to me.
Short version, one of Harry's med techs snuck a relative on board. Woke them up, cut them loose. Turns out this relative has a rare illness. Not contagious yet, but in the later stages.
That was stupid.
They exposed the whole station to a potentially contagious illness?
Yes. We need to keep this quiet and handle it fast. This gets out, we'll have a station-wide panic. Besides, this is a Hyperion matter. My responsibility.
This concerns everyone. We're part of the Nexus now.
Contagion rumors on stations never end well. Never. I've been through this before. The only way this ends without major losses is if we handle things before the rumors get out.
Right. I'll look into it.
Good.
Okay, what is there to look
Talk into? To Harry. He can brief you on the details. Let's bring this under control before it's too late.
And who's Harry? Damn, there's so many people! Oh, kiss my ass. Now I can go back to the cryo bay. Well, I'll get back there when I can, I guess. You have anything interesting?
Pathfinder?
Nope.
Have to go.
Goodbye. Alrighty. This should be taking us to SAM node. Yes, SAM node. Woohoo! Should get a new memory.
Writer, one of your father's memories is available.
Let's see it.
This memory is of a family gathering on Earth.
Finally, the Ryder clan in one room. It feels like it's been years since we were together.
Or more.
Well, I'll take whatever I can get. I've missed you two.
How are you feeling, Mom?
No, we're not doing that. There's only one rule for this visit. No talking about me. I'm fine. And when I'm not, the pills help. Deal?
Okay.
Good. Let's talk about something else. Alec? Really?
Well, you're both looking taller.
Yeah, Dad, that does tend to happen.
Right, I know. So, I heard the Alliance has a new Mako in the works.
Yeah, word is they can airdrop this one from a ship.
I know. They're saying we might get one on our next expedition.
You still poking around the attic in Traverse?
It's amazing. We think we might have found a Prothean site. No artifacts yet, but we're still digging.
I remember the day they found the first ruins on Mars. Changed my life. We knew for sure that aliens were real. We just had to go find them.
Yes, every day I wake up, I'm looking at a Mass Effect relay, and I keep thinking, what's on the other side?
Don't lose that. The minute you stop wondering what's beyond the mountain, you die a little inside.
No chance of that. It's in our blood. You infected us.
What was it like, Dad, when you went through that first relay?
Don't believe the stories. The Garon relay scared the shit out of us, Admiral Grissom included. Why don't we go have this dinner your mom's been slaving over all day? I'll tell you all about it.
Family moment.
I remember that. Mom complained the Ryder clan was never in the same room at the same time.
Odd, considering you were family.
That's all you need to know. Dad wasn't much fun to hang around with. The awkward silences could last for hours.
Yet you shared a common interest.
Yeah, good or bad, your parents rub off on you.
A form of symbiosis?
Sure, I suppose. Though not always beneficial.
It gave rise to you.
Jury's still out on that.
Nevertheless, the emotional bonds among family became clear to me that day. Your progress as Pathfinder has unlocked an additional memory.
Alright, well then let's play it.
Let's see it.
This memory is when Alec first learned the initiative.
It will be just a moment. Hello, Alec.
I'm too old for cloak and dagger. I got your message. I'm here. Who are you?
A benefactor, if you like.
You have something to offer me?
A future.
That's vague.
A future for your wife. You're out of money. Your contacts have dried up. You can't finish Sam.
How do you know about...
I can help you. Whatever you need.
Start by telling me what you need.
Your AI is more than a cure for your wife. It could also be the salvation for many others.
I don't follow.
Where we're going, we'll need a different perspective to understand things.
Where's that? The Andromeda Galaxy?
I have a proposal for you. And Ellen doesn't have much time. Are you interested?
Who was that? The benefactor?
I believe there was more to the Andromeda Initiative than was publicly understood. Private logs are now available in your father's quarters. They may shed further light on the matter. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it.
Shadow Broker, maybe?
That's all for now.
Of course.
Because I do recall the Shadow Broker saying something that, like, he was taking steps to ensure certain things as well. I could be wrong.
Your father's personal logs.
I had a strange meeting yesterday. I thought it would be with Jen Garson, who founded the initiative. But it wasn't. I guess Jen's the visionary, the one who gets everyone excited about the project and drums up publicity. But then this benefactor apparently provides resources and money. And I mean a lot of money. It's a little unusual. But everything about this project is.
Interesting. I wonder if Director Tan knows anything about this. Worth talking to him.
So the only thing, only people from the previous series I could think of that had that kind of cash were the Elusive Man and the Shadow Broker.
I accepted the Initiative's offer. They're calling me a Pathfinder. There's no other option left. Sam will never happen without their help. Our savings are gone, and no one will return my calls. I am a pariah. There's something strange going on with this benefactor. But Ellen's getting worse. I can't fail her.
Okay. All right, log off. Let's see what else is next. Was this here before?
When studying a dead race, the most obvious problem is the lack of an observable population. This raises the question, when is a species truly extinct? The Prothean civilization spanned the galaxy, and it took centuries to confirm that all members of the species really had died out. While it's possible that living Protheans may be found in a hidden pocket of the galaxy one day, the chances are statistically trivial. Once an extinction is confirmed, the study's nature moves from sociology to exoarchaeology.
Okay, maybe I did listen to that at one point. Moving on. Oh my god, I'm looking at the time and we're almost at an hour already. Jeez. Let's get the heck... Oh yeah, we gotta go back to the cryo bay. I do remember that, but I don't remember what for. So let's go do that.
As sleepers wake from stasis, the initiative urgently requires blood, tissue, and DNA donations. See a medic if you think you may be eligible. This is HNS.
Wouldn't everybody technically be eligible for, like, most of that? Ah, oh, I'm an idiot. I went to the wrong section. Cryo Bay is where I want to be.
Construction and repairs continue on various parts of the Nexus. Authorities have no word on completion and remind visitors to avoid affected areas. This is HNS.
Okay, what are we here to find again?
This is not good. Damned exiles.
Well, you look suspicious. Maybe Dr. Carlyle's supposed to talk to?
Good you're here. Dunn briefed you.
High level only. Said to speak with you for the full brief.
Great. Well then, here we go. Before we left, my med tech Charlie helped his aunt sign on to the initiative program.
He cheated the screening process?
Yeah. She has TH314. Deadly, highly contagious in the latter stages and jumps across species. It was dormant, but flared up when Charlie woke her. He just assumed it was stasis sickness. There's no cure, no vaccine. It's deadly in its final stage, and she's off-grid. She's a problem.
That does not sound good.
What should I know about this TH314?
Stage 1 symptoms are similar to stasis sickness, which is what fooled Charlie. Stage 2 is marked by extreme bouts of paranoia. It becomes virulently contagious at stage 3. Airborne, the works.
Is anyone else infected?
No one so far. According to the test results I received after Charlie left, she's still in stage 1. If she progresses to stage 3, Ryder, it'll be bad. It's a rare disease, but the kind that starts pandemics.
Any idea where he's gone?
Not long ago, he was assigned to an Apex unit for a mission. Incommunicado at the moment. Charlie had no idea the virus would flare up after stasis. Virology isn't his specialty. She's his only relative. Even so, he should have known better.
We need to help her, you mean?
Every instinct I have, both medical and human, is screaming at me to help her. Making sure TH-314 doesn't spread is the top priority, no matter what. This one isn't going to be easy.
Anything else I need to know?
Be quick, but discreet. We can't panic the entire station over this.
I only have a whole space station to search. Discreetly. Check.
Could be worse. She could be off station and potentially infecting the Angara. Try customs first. Even with fake medical clearance, she had to go through there like anyone else.
Dr. Carlyle has granted me access to Ruth Becker's profile. The file includes her physical description.
That'll be useful. Thanks, Sam.
Okay. Now, move along. Let's go to the command center. My last couple of videos were pretty short, so I believe we'll go a little long on this one to make up a bit for it so we can get... I'm hoping to get most of the stuff done.
The recent uprising as security tightens across all sectors on the Nexus.
Here on the Nexus.
Director Tan stresses that it's, quote, for your safety.
And then head out for, like, a bunch of extended space ops again. I like being able to do that. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to make our normal rounds. We'll start off at the left and make our way to the right.
I'm sorry, Lana. I don't know. It was all hazy.
It seems like some records were mixed up and you were getting the wrong info. They give some people psychotic episodes. You got real unlucky.
So I can go?
Pathfinder, maybe you can clear this up.
How can I help?
My friend Jory was on Eos the first go-round, barely survived. Now they want him to go back.
They're saying the conditions are improved, that it's safe now, is it?
It's safe.
You can believe the reports. Eos is becoming a livable and sustainable space. Going back to reclaim it will help heal your scars.
See, Jory? It's going to be okay.
Thank you, Pathfinder. I'll do that.
Okay. You're welcome, buddy. You're welcome.
Maintenance crews, please report to the
console. Same stuff. Am I supposed to be scanning for anything? I don't know.
Where's that relief?
How about you?
What's up?
No more. All right, there's
Sid.
Can
I talk to you, Ryder?
Yes, Sid.
Good that you're here, Ryder. I found something while monitoring comms for the Nexus. Multiple attacks by people called the Three Sabers. They're hitting outposts and supply vessels. The really weird part is they seem aware of our operations, like they're getting intel.
Oh, Mole?
What are you saying? That someone's feeding them info?
Maybe. It would be really bad if that were true, right? I've reported it, and they say they'll investigate, but then forget. But you're the Pathfinder. If someone's betraying the Nexus, you have to do something about it.
It's absolutely
If they seem to know our operations, that could spell trouble. Best to get to the bottom of it.
Thank you. I knew I could count on you. Best Pathfinder ever. I don't know where they hide, but I got the nav points for their most recent raids. Maybe the Tempest scanners can figure out where they went.
Let's investigate it. Because I'm the bestest ever Esterus Pathfinder.
Apex team leaders reporting back.
Certified with their firearms.
I can't. A new species? What if I...
Okay, you say the same
thing. You know,
things.
Offend them. Screw up everything our
How
diplomats...
No news on the Turian Arc yet. Or is this militia business?
Nada.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Okay. We're gonna head upstairs. Reception.
Attention, civil disobedience has been reported in hydroponics.
Go talk to...
Good to see you.
Mr. Kane. Oh, another guy. Sellers.
Excuse me, Pathfinder. I don't know where else to turn. My best friend's been missing since the revolts.
Tell me.
He was involved with a woman who was exiled. She obsessed over him, and I'm sure she kidnapped him. The powers that be don't buy it and don't care. They say most likely he went willingly.
Did he love her?
Love can make us do strange things.
He didn't love her. She was just a fling.
The initiative has branded him a traitor. I don't want that to be his legacy. I want to clear his name, Sanjeev Clement. The woman was Delaney Bruce. She must have taken him to Kadara.
Pathfinder, those names match a lock we found. Clement tried to escape, and Bruce killed him.
Oh.
We've already heard tell of him. I'm sorry. Your friend didn't make it.
I knew it. Poor Sanjeev.
It's small consolation, but I relayed the record to Director Tan. Sanjeev's name will be cleared.
That matters. I'd already made peace with the idea that I'd never see him again. I'm so grateful.
Wow, we just kind of
Superintendent Cash
found stuff that we didn't even know we found. And that is one of the big issues I kind of have. There was something I wanted to do while I was in this menu and show you guys. Don't remember what that was. But that is a major problem I have. Oh, we have even more priority ops now. This is to Remov system. Reports of an interesting... Oh, okay, that's the lucrative planet. A new world. Drak is concerned about tensions at the Krogan colony. Okay. I would like to see these missions organized in a better fashion. Some way, somehow, I don't know. They're just so much thrown at you. And you kind of don't... It's really hard to keep track of what's what, I should say. But once again, let me shut up.
Hi, Ryder.
Cool. Oh, that is the viability. Cora, can I hit on you? Please tell me I can hit on you. Damn it! I had planned on ending up with Cora in this playthrough.
Nothing to fear from the people of the Milky Way. But do you have anything to offer? Our wisdom.
Oh, we've heard that.
I see you've crossed paths with Sloane Kelly and the Exiles. A thorn in our side, if ever there was one.
Two sides to the story there, buddy.
I don't think anyone came all the way to Andromeda to live like that. The Nexus was part of this, too.
It's about the future, Ryder. What sort of civilization will we form in Helios? One driven to extremes of anarchy, or one dedicated to order and justice? I choose the latter. Sloane Kelly and her mutineers chose otherwise. Did you have some other business?
Mysterious benefactor.
I'm curious. What do you know about the people who backed the initiative?
What everyone knows. Gian Carson was the founder and visionary. Unfortunately, she died on the Nexus during the Scourge disaster.
Is there anyone else?
I would almost welcome them. A voice to silence the rabble. Then Kesh might listen. But no, we're alone. Why do you ask?
I hate how he talks about other people, like the rabble. The commoners.
I have information that suggests Garson wasn't the only one.
What sort of information?
It's complicated, but there was a silent partner. A benefactor.
Even if that were true, we've been here 14 months with no sign of them. This partner is either a phantom, missing, or dead. Nope, Gian Garson was the beacon. A sad end to someone of such stature. Dying alone.
Oh?
It was chaos. By the time they found her, she was already dead, succumbed to her injuries.
Was there a follow-up investigation?
I wasn't even out of stasis, but knowing the violence of the Scourge disaster, death was everywhere. If you're suggesting something else happened, Ryder, I'd rather you didn't. Let's not add to the confusion.
Thank you for your time.
Ryder, if you wish to pursue this further, accessing Nexus security records may reveal more information.
Hi, Ryder.
Okay, well, we know where Nexus Security is, so let's go ahead and do that while we got it fresh on our minds. And then we'll head up and talk to Mrs. My Face is Tired. And then we may end the video shortly after. Okay. Missing persons report. Jay Garson. Okay, so this was the one that was added to the records, right? Oh, excuse me, got the hiccups. Andromeda Initiative founder Gian Garson has been reported missing. She was last seen during the emergency stasis revival that occurred after the Scourge encounter. A bulletin had been issued. Garson investigation closed. Addendum. Update to the missing files reported. Update to the missing pile. Wow. Update to the missing persons report filed on Jean Garson. Maintenance crew found her body in a Nexus apartment. Severe burns were apparent, similar to those we saw who were killed during the Scourge disaster. It's unclear how she got there, but confusion and disorientation during the Scourge event are likely. Events align with the timeline. Cause of death, causality, the Scourge disaster. Case closed.
The only hard fact is that her body was found in one of the apartments.
Then connecting her death to the Scourge disaster was mere speculation.
Yeah, they just wanted this to go away. I think we need to check out that apartment.
Environmental data will allow us to reconstruct the scene.
Attention, civil disobedience. Well, I think that is actually going to be on our way back out, so perfect. All right, miss. Whoa, wait.
May I have a word?
What is it?
You're out there, facing the cat. We hear only rumors making them out to be monsters. Maybe they just don't understand us. Do you think peace could ever be possible?
Anything's possible.
We don't know the future. Given time, I'd like to think there's always a chance.
If you have hope, I'll have hope. I hope I live to see it. Thank you for your time.
Oh, you're welcome, buddy. Everybody needs an uplifting speech every now and then. Oh, that's what I saw. Let's go talk to the Krogans. Oh, wow, another one.
What's going on? Why are you whispering?
I'm planning a surprise for Superintendent Kesh. She's always complaining that our stock of spirits is tame. I hear Kadara-Part is famous for bizarre homebrews. Supposedly pack a powerful punch. Hoping you can pick some up and keep it quiet.
Got it.
I'll see if I can find some.
Excellent.
Oh shit.
Shh.
B-double-E-double-R-U-N, Pyrrha.
I'm worried about this place.
B-double-E-double-R-U-N, Pyrrha.
Then we... Pathfinder.
Run. Done for now.
Nothing more for now.
Try not to die out there.
What is that strange sound? Drac, you got anything to say, buddy?
Attention, civil disobedience.
Hey, Ryder.
Hey, how about you stay still so I can activate you? Thank you.
Kid?
Oh, well, that wasn't worth it. All we need is beer, some keys, and a fire. Screw that lineup. That's it.
We're done here.
Security is investigating.
All we need is keys and a driver. Fake ID and a silverware driver. B-double-E-double-R-U-N-B-Run.
Pathfinder.
Even though I've already asked, I want to see her speak.
How are we doing on the viability front?
Aiming for success. It sounds pat, but you're living up to the job.
It looks better.
How are we doing on the viability front?
Aiming for success. It sounds pat, but you're living up to the job.
Okay, well,
Director Addison?
Goodbye, Pathfinder.
I like your attitude change from before. So, I think we are going to leave things here. And when we come back, we're just going to continue. We're going to finish up a few little things here on the Nexus, and then we're going to get going. It's taken us a while to get there, but I hope to get a lot more episodes out really soon. Now that I have the weekend off, I have my computer thankfully dialed in, so we'll see. All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.